summer shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. How fit to be the boss, let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York,
show. I just wanna see more dress though. Itchy throwing, I'ma catch those. Mexican, dummy pesos. Itchy sauce, I'ma replace those. Number six, though.
We need more, tell them we need more. Put numbers on the board, let them keep the score. Hey, 16 cars in my yard. Hey, 30 on my wrist, but
big numbers, big numbers. 100-minute bag, that's a big number. Big numbers.
Yeah, wrist man, check the wrist man, got him hot. Ain't like this man, Lord. Pass the pig skin when he stretch a distance. I'm talking a few hundred thousand yards, you just on your fifth grand. Run it up, 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 count it up. Ayy, hundreds and fifties and twenties, no fives and no singles, don't count on them. Ayy, she wanted like me, cause I blame she can't count on him. She tried to be nosy and hit up my ex, she like, girl, you can count on him.
Hey, hey, we need more, tell him we need more. Putting numbers on the board, let them keep the score. Hey, 16 cars in my front yard. Hey, 30 on my wrist, bullet points a car.
Big numbers, big numbers. 100-minute bag, that's a big number. Big numbers, big numbers. Whole team counted, that's a big number. Big numbers, big numbers.
Okay, Coach. Well, the road ends here. It has been a wild, often unpredictable 2019 season. And now it's time for the greatest spectacle in all of sports. Super Bowl 54 from Miami. You know, this town has played host to 10 Super Bowls in the past. And tonight, we write chapter number 11. And what a matchup we've got. Tonight, it's all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy, as it'll be the AFC champion Oakland Raiders taking on the five-time Super Bowl champs from the NFC, the Dallas Cowboys. Brandon Gaudin and Charles Davis, very pleased to be with you. And the story, Charles, of the Oakland Raiders season, just an incredible one, really, in the East Bay. Folks not expecting much after a 4-12 season in 2018. Fans were coming to terms with saying goodbye. And then a funny thing happened. The Raiders started to win, and they did not stop.
And what a way to go out this would be. I mean, this is like storybook. This is something that you write, and you put it on film, and people...
And oh, his first carry, he loses the football. And it's picked up by the Cowboys. And his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line. Of course, they have the option, and they choose to not take the penalty.
They like the results of the play that they just ran, and they elect to let them stand.
So the special teams penalty cost some yardage there as they come out on first and 10.
Here we go, D. Race don't travel. Here I come again. Check the hot read.
Watch the ad.
Watch twist.
From the shotgun again to Elliott. And right away, they're going to stack him up right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. Second down.
Well, that didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
Check 50.
Double up.
He's coming. Double up.
Jim.
One.
On second down, Elliott. And a short gain down to about the 33. The second down play, not much better than the first, just a gain of one there.
I know the speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
So they've been unable to capitalize on the great field position as of yet. Here's third and 9.
Check 43.
One.
High 7,
let's go.
From the shotgun, it's Mariota. His throw caught at about the 5. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. They'll try to run it in with Elliott, and he will take it in for a Cowboy score. With the first touchdown of this Super Bowl, as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. Striking first in any game is very important, but on this stage, the biggest of stages in the Super Bowl, that's huge.
You fully expect the other team to battle all the way through, but when you're the one setting the pace, jumping out in front, that has to feel great for the entire organization.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Raider offense set to get this drive started, and they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
Now they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. Now Carr, after the incomplete pass, brings him up second and 10. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4.
It's a gain of 4. Brings up third and 6.
Wait, what? Now! 180! 54, Mike.
Yeah, that's what I do.
Throwing his car on third down. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
It's a nice job hitting him on the angle route there. Coming out of the backfield, cutting sharply across the middle. And that's good timing between the quarterback and his receiver.
Effective third down play to move the chains.
Pilot, 64, weak.
Here's Jacobs on first and 10.
Here we go.
10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Partner, I remember a coaching friend of mine used to tell his running backs before games, make sure you run and jog with your offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking when those big behemoths start to create space for you up front. He did a pretty good job of just following those guys through there for a nice explosive run.
Hey, check 24, check 24.
They'll run it now. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. 2 yards, good enough for a first.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot down as he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
Mike 54. Hey, they scared. They scared. Check 31. Check 31.
Carr now on first down. Being chased out left. He'll get 10 there all on his own, but it'll be second down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
Right there, 54, Mike. Check, 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 check. Check, check, check. Nickel, nickel, nickel.
On second down, Jacobs. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. That backs him up 1 yard and brings up third down. Carr to throw on third and one. Over the middle, it's complete. And he's going to. Another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 26.
First down. First and 10 at the 26-yard line.
Hey, Bill! 185! 54! Mike, 54! I'm coming for you! You hunter!
That was the ninth play of the drive, and they pick up 9 yards with it. And boy, they had high praise for this rookie receiver when we asked the coaches about him, didn't they?
They certainly did, and obviously they liked his measurables, otherwise they wouldn't have brought him onto the team. Height, weight, speed, all of that. But how about what they really said? Competitiveness. That's what they really liked about him. The way he goes after the football, competes for it, and decides when it's in the air, it's his and only his.
Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
That's incomplete, but there is a flag down, so hang on. A big call coming on third down. That's on the big guard, Gabe Jackson.
Now,
They had the incomplete pass on second down. Now they need a big play here, 3rd and 10. Shotgun now for Carr. Forced out to it, and he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Leighton Vander Esch wreaking havoc with a sack. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. And this will split the uprights. It's right down the middle. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. A dozen plays on that drive that ends with the field goal.
Let's go ahead and break out some of the old chestnuts here, right, partner? Keep the ball in front, rally to it, and make the tackle. Right? No big plays given up. No balls over your head. Bend, don't break.
Hold on, hold on. Chestnuts?
You like
Come
that
on.
One?
What does that mean, break out? Just because you break chestnuts?
I'm not sure about that, but I'm just going with why they said that. I have no idea.
They start on the ground with Elliott. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
From the 29, Mariota. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Lamb. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up 3rd down. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff, didn't
they? Yeah,
when
we talked about him, they did.
Yeah, you know, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time. Really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things continue to move on.
His first catch of this Super Bowl, and it'll be good for a 1st down. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on 1st and 10. They go play action. Mariota. And that's Elliott complete. And this winds up a pickup of 2, maybe 2.5 to about the 39.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
So 2nd and 8 here after the pass play for 2 yards on 1st down.
Watch the twist. Watch the twist. Kill, kill, kill. Turn up. Kill, kill, kill. Turn up.
One.
They'll throw again. Mariota. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on. 3rd down.
He kind of forced that one there, didn't he? It's almost like he predetermined where he was going to go with the football.
Yeah, he wasn't really going through progressions. He wanted to go to his top guy. You do that against this defense, they'll make you pay, won't they?
Yeah, they certainly will. They react very quickly to the thrown football.
Mike 54. Mike
1-1-1.
Get ready. Get ready.
On 3rd down, Mariota. And he'll have his man. That's Cooper. And he's going to have another 1st down as the tackle comes at the Raiders 42.
Partner, this is one of the best routes anyone can have in their offensive playbook. Tough to defend because you think it's a go route, and then he breaks it back on the comeback. There's one other thing you need as well.
A well-thrown ball.
Exactly right. You have a guy who has some precision in throwing the football because of the timing of the route.
Mariota now to throw on 1st down. That's caught by his tight end, Evan Engram. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up 2nd down.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
Hey, hey, watch it, watch it. Check 37, check.
One.
To throw again on 2nd down. Mariota looking deep in the direction of Cooper. And this is going to wind up incomplete. The coverage there too strong on the deep ball, and now they face a third down. Those passes out that far wide always make you hold your breath a little bit. Felt like it was in the air for a while.
What it does is allows a defender to gain some ground, come from a long distance, and have a chance to affect the pass.
Check, check. Lucky.
Again, it's Mariota. He finds his man, Johnson. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. They get only four that time as that leads us to a fourth down. Zerline's kick is up and through. And they push the lead up to a touchdown now at 10-3. These kickers now, it's like we take them for granted. Kicks like that used to be such a big deal, and now you just expect them to make it.
Yeah, you're exactly right, and we shouldn't take them for granted. But I have a theory about it. You want to hear it?
Yep.
They are more athletic now than ever before. Talk about kickers. Trace their backgrounds, trace their history. You'll find that they were big-time athletes all along, but their kicking was so prevalent that we made them specialists. Yeah,
and now those 50-plus yarders seem easy for some reason. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. Just a lone field goal for them so far, trailing 10-3 as they come up first and 10. On the ground, it's Jacobs to start the drive. And he'll get about four across the 30 to the 32.
They don't want it, fellas. They don't want it. Keep playing hard, fellas.
2 minutes even on the clock in the first half of Super Bowl 54. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me in this booth, and he's miles away and smiling.
And happy.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 19 yards the pick up there. Move the chains. On first down, Carr. Flushed out right. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
It's been my observation, there's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit, but only the second quarter, a lot of time to change things. Carr again here on second and 10. This will be caught, Tyrell Williams. And oh, he's going to be brought down by the face mask. Here come the flags.
Let's go, let's go.
This is going to get him a first down.
What
after
now?
The penalty, a fresh set of downs. It's first and 10. Working from the gun, it's Carr. Play here, and that's complete. Down he goes at the 23, a pickup of four. 4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and 6. And it's caught, and he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. 23 yards for the touchdown, as they are an extra point away now from tying this football game. Extra point right down the middle, and that is going to tie our game as we approach halftime. All level now at 10 apiece as the kick's away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And we're under a minute to go here. What's been an even first half, all tied up.
Yeah, still time to make something happen, too. Couple completions, you string them together. Could get into field goal range. Let's see what happens.
They'll start the drive with Elliott. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime. The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8.
Hey, Alpha. Check mic 54.
looking for Cooper. That's complete. The reception good for seven. It's third down.
People worry about throwing the out route because often it can get jumped, and that can turn into either an incompletion or an interception. But not on that one. Everything came together, and he catches it and goes over the sideline.
Under 10, under 10, 10.
Mike's by four, Mike's by four, Mike's by four.
And I'm coming after you, I'm coming after you. Kill, 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 kill.
On third and one, here's Mariota. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Max Crosby coming in to drop him for a loss of eight, and it also brings up fourth. The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. So on fourth down, here's Chris Jones to punt it away. Hold in at the 32. Yards on the return, but for a moment looked like he had a shot to go all the way. And the Raiders will have a short field to work with as they take over. From the 34 now, here's first and 10.
Hey, 7:34.
Carr gonna give it to Jacobs. He'll get the first down and more inside the 20. Good yardage as he rumbles for 24 and a first.
Oh, that's a big one right there. You talk about breaking off a huge chunk of real estate. But if you're the defensive coordinator, you cannot dwell on the fact you just gave up an explosive run. You have to look ahead, regroup your guys, and figure out a way to slow down this attack.
Now a first carry for their fullback. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. Now the Raiders going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. And Carr's going to keep it himself. Not even a chance to pitch that one as he's swallowed up in the backfield. Now here's a timeout as they're going to get it with 8 seconds remaining here in the first half. Now this time, Carl throw, and it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked up by Leighton Vander Esch. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Time here for likely one play, and then these two teams will head to the locker room all even.
And you know the play caller's just feeling it right now. Let's go ahead and go for this one. A big shot down. No, no, no. Guaranteed the head coach is like, don't get crazy. Take the knee. Let's get out of here. Tie game. We'll just start all over.
All right, coach. Thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Tedious halftime show behind us, and now it's back to football as we get going again in Super Bowl 54. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback.
Ready.
about set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter three.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum to begin the half. What do they have dialed up that'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield?
Let's find out what they have dialed up.
At the 26-yard line.
Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run.
Hey, what's that? Hey, what's the block?
Three.
From the gun, Mariota. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far. It brings up third down. After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and nine.
Watch safety creep. Watch safety creep.
Three.
Safety's creeping.
He's coming. We got double up.
One.
Zoom, fellas. Let's go.
Working out of the gun, Mariota. The open man is Smith. His second catch of the Super Bowl, and it's good enough for a first down. Carry by Elliott. And this will be taken across midfield and into Raider territory. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and two.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy is carrying a ball behind them, can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
Right there. 54 Mike.
They go to Elliott again. And he'll get it down here to the 43. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
Second and two is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down, keep the sticks moving.
Mike's by four.
Got to do better.
Three.
Check. Crunch.
Check.
Check.
10th carry now for Elliott. And some room to run now. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10. And mark him at the 5. 38 yards on the scamper there. He covered a lot of ground, great blocking, and now they can sniff that end zone.
They certainly can, and because of that run, maybe you come back and fake it to him on this play and throw a little play action. Someone should break wide open.
Wide. Get wide.
Kill.
Check.
Check three. H3, 218. Chopper.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage. Back at the 6. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down.
Anytime you call an inside running play, you just know there should be a lot of congestion there. You're counting on your offensive line to take control of the line of scrimmage. That didn't happen in this case, and that play got bottled up.
Second and goal from the 6 this time. Stepping up, he's going to keep it, and he's going to pull this one forward as they stop it right around the 1. He'll get 5 out of the keeper, but now it's third down. They've gotten it to the 1. Can they get that final yard here on third and goal?
Out.
Here's Elliott, and he'll get in. Touchdown, Cowboys. Ezekiel Elliott, his second touchdown of this Super Bowl, and the Cowboys have taken the lead. Now Zerline on to add the extra point. He's got it as they go up by a total of 17 to 10. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This fielded at the two. Oh, able to avoid him. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. And this game was all square at halftime, but now they find themselves down 7 following the opening drive touchdown here in the third quarter.
And they need to take a good, relaxing, deep breath, don't you think? Because right now they might start to feel like they've got to play catch-up here and start matching them point for point. But it's still too early to get there. They can still run their offense. Plenty of time to get back in this game.
Takes this down deep on the Cowboys side of the field. And he's going to get this all the way down to the Cowboys 16-yard line. A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. And he'll take this one down near the 15. Give him maybe a yard, quite the opposite from the previous big gainer.
Oftentimes we praise an offense for their variety of being able to hit people with the run and the pass, but in this game, how about what we're seeing from the safeties? They are all over the field. Doesn't matter if they threw it or if they're trying to run it.
I don't think we've ever awarded an MVU most valuable unit, but you're right, it might go to them in this game.
I like that, MVU. Well done.
On second and 9, Carr looking end zone, but it's incomplete. After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on 3rd and 9. From the gun, it's Carr. Escaping the pressure right. He can run for it, and he will. 5 yards that time out of the scramble. But now they're looking at a 4th down situation.
Well, partner, nothing comes open here, so he decides to escape out of there, and he doesn't pick up a 1st down, but he does gain additional yardage to set up a possible field goal attempt if they decide to go that route.
And his kick is good. And that will cut this lead back down to 4 now. It's 17-13. So they put together a good little drive there, but ultimately stalling out in the red zone.
Yeah, I know a lot of people look at it as a little bit of a negative. They didn't get 6 points out of it, right? Didn't get the touchdown. But that's actually okay. They got 3 points, able to give their defense a little bit of rest, let them settle down over there. So all in all, to me, that's a good drive.
The lead cut to just 4 as they kick it away and turn things over to their D. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And that last drive, it was all about the ground game, ground and pound.
And I don't care how we're playing the game these days, offensive linemen still want to fire out and smack the guy opposite them and move the football on the ground. They feel better about that. That's what they want to do. That's how they want to play, and that's how they got it done.
Yeah, they got it for a touchdown last drive. Let's see what happens here. An incomplete pass leads to 2nd and 10 from the 25. Elliott. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It's a gain of 16 in the Dallas first down.
Well, it is our business to analyze what we saw out there. And on that play, I saw defense staying in base, not taking a chance, not blitzing in a situation when they absolutely need the football back. That's either a case of overthinking it or not thinking it through.
If you do blitz, do you have to be careful about where you're coming from, or are you just coming from all angles?
You have to be careful about where you're coming from, obviously. But at this stage, you have to take a few chances as well.
Brings up second and five at the 46-yard line.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five.
Hey, watch the slant. Watch the slant. Check three.
Check. One.
Out of the gun, it's Elliott. And down he goes at the 49, a three-yard pickup.
That gives him 98 yards in this game, and he's got to feel pretty good about that, but the entire offense does. The big thing, though, Brandon, they've got to get to 100, though.
You think he knows he's at 98?
I think someone's told him by now. And here's the thing. Getting to 100 or more is tangible evidence that you've had a nice day running the football, and that's what his offensive line wants for him and for themselves.
His second catch of the Super Bowl, and it's good enough for a first down.
Couldn't just sit on it here, could they? Had to throw the ball on third down. Got the big completion in the pickup. Fresh set of downs now. They've got to feel great.
And defensively, a backbreaker.
Here we go.
So here's a first and 10 now in Raider territory at the 44-yard line. Here's Elliott. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. 11 yards and a Cowboy first down. Well, that looked like an example of what you said back in the first half. A running back of his size can really wear down a defense. I think he's starting to do that.
I think you're exactly right. And know what else he's doing? He's inspiring the rest of his team because they see this starting to happen as well. So that means they're going to redouble their efforts to help him out. Extra blocking, getting downfield, helping him out.
They keep on the ground with Elliott. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. It's a gain of 12, and the Cowboys pick up the first.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old-school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
Saw it through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. They'll run on first down. Elliott, and I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. Call it a loss of two on the play, and it'll be second and 12. They'll try to throw now, Mariota. And he's got his man on the out route. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the...
That's a gain of five. Brings up third and eight.
One of the bigger plays in the game thus far. The crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down.
Check, 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 check.
One. Three.
Check 13.
Showing up.
Hayward.
Mariota to throw it. Over the middle, complete. That's Lamb. And he's able to pick up the first down before he's tackled right at the 10. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. The clock showing 2 minutes even in what's been a memorable Super Bowl 54. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got it first and goal as they search for what could be a game-sealing touchdown. Now Elliott. And a short pickup there down to about the 9. So fresh out of the 2-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. Ball situated at the 9, second and goal.
Hey, watch the slant, watch the slant. Watch the slant, watch the slant. Shift, shift.
3-3-3.
Shift, shift, shift. Check 9, check 9. Joker, joker.
They'll try again with Elliott. Slipped one tackle, but no more as he's knocked to the deck behind the line of scrimmage. Now the Raiders going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts, as he'll talk it over here before what'll be an important third down. Now the Cowboys gonna burn the first of their timeouts, as he'll talk it over here before what'll be an important third down. They'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. And Zuerlein's kick is good. And that'll make this a 7-point game. But from a defensive perspective, though, I think maybe they're saying, hey, we did what we needed to do, kept this a one-score game.
Yeah, without a doubt, because they were able to bleed some time off the clock, right? Put themselves in a good position, but it's not out of reach yet, okay? Being able to hold them to a field goal means that they do have a chance to come back and win this game.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete. So he's unable to complete it there, and just not the game that you would expect from him. He's been off the mark, really, start to finish.
Yeah, it makes you wonder what exactly is going on. Is he a little bit dinged up here, or is he just off just by a bit? Maybe he can get it back in this situation. He'll need to.
He's back to throw. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down. So back-to-back incompletions, now third and 10. And first things first, before you think about marching the ball down the field, you got to move the chains.
You're exactly right. Got to get back into focus here. Get the first down. That's what's vital to them.
Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
29. 29.
The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. Able to find Walter. That's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 14 yards is the pickup there at a Raider first. The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. Back to throw. flush to his right. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. The wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down. Got out of the pocket. Didn't look like he had anybody open, Charles, so just gets rid of it.
And a good play by him. If no one's open and you don't have a running lane that you want to take, make the right choice. Get rid of it. Live to fight another down.
Back to throw. That's complete to his tight end, Waller. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Into the red zone. It's called. That'll be incomplete as the clock will stop with 14 seconds remaining. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Now Carr, after the incomplete pass, brings him up second and 10. They'll look to throw. And it's incomplete, broken up. But there is a flag down. Let's see what that's about. So the defense helping him out a little bit here late in the fourth.
Man, you're exactly right. And when you're the one doing the chasing, you'll take a little help from the other guys, won't you?
A looming decision to make on the conversion, down seven. But first things first, they need to score as they come up on first and goal. And his ball is caught. It's a touchdown. And now in the final seconds, they're a PAT away from likely getting this thing to overtime. Now still down one. Here's an utterly critical extra point attempt here. The kick is through the uprights to tie this game, but hang on a second, we do have a flag. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. It'll be a loss of a yard, and it'll be second and 11. Overtime in a playoff game. Awesome setup. Remember, the rules the same as they would be in the regular season.
That's exactly right, Brandon. Remember, the receiving team, if they score a touchdown, game is over. But if they kick a field goal or don't score, the other team gets a chance to get the football. They get a possession. If they go down and score, they win the football game at that point. If both teams kick field goals, we keep playing. If a defense scores, let's say the receiving team gets the ball, doesn't score, or they throw a pick six or fumble, gets picked up, the defense scores, game over. But here's the best part. In a regular season, only one period is played. We could call it a tie. Here, we're going to play until we have a winner.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. They control their own destiny here. They have the football in overtime. Obviously, a touchdown would win it.
And I think teams around the league are still adjusting to the idea of going downfield, scoring a touchdown wins the game, because they were used to just going downfield and trying to get in field goal range to win a game. Still having to make that transition, let's face it now, the ones who are doing it best know they need to go down, attack, put the ball in the end zone, and not leave it up to a field goal and give the other team a chance.
As we said, they control their own destiny now. First throw of overtime for Carr. the connection here with Nelson Aguilar. A gain there of 21 yards.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
They'll run on first down. It's Jacobs, and taking it across midfield and inside the 45. A pickup of 10, and it's enough for an Oakland first down. So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 at the 44-yard line. On first down, they go with Jacobs again. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a second and 6. Carr. And he will go down. A Cowboys sack. DeMarcus Lawrence. He's the one that got home and takes him down for a loss of 9.
Enough takes a start to have a good drive. Quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
Now they're looking at a third and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
Now Carr is going to fire one deep up. That's caught inside the 20. A gain of 32 that time.
I know we love our jobs, and pretty much any play we see, we're pretty, excited about. But big plays, let's face it, that's what we absolutely live for. How about that one?
That was great. And what our camera missed was the fist pump from the sideline after that catch. They're fired out. That's a big game.
So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. On first down, Jacobs. And they'll lose yardage here. Knocked back to the 19-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of 1 on first down. Bear in mind, that wasn't a big lineman back there for the tackle for loss. That was a cornerback.
So are you saying the myth has been shattered? That all of them are not just cover corners? Some of them actually will stick their nose in and tackle when necessary? That's what we just saw, isn't it?
Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. Shotgun now for Carr. And he slings one that's incomplete.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, and as it turned out, couldn't even find his outlet man because of the coverage. It was way too tight. Unable to find anyone open.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. Now throwing on third down there, but he cannot connect.
I think that was a good job there defensively. They did. To drive all the way downfield, but once they got their backs to the goal line, they really turned up the pressure.
Yeah, they let them get all the way down here. Now the field shrinks. They've struggled to convert, and that last incompletion brings up 4. They're able to put 3 on the board here on the opening drive of OT, and now up to their defense to try and see if they can hold this one.
I like how you framed it up, because obviously this game is not over, right? They go down and kick a field goal, then we head to sudden death. But if the defense can hold, take the ball away, turn it over on downs, this game's over.
Go, go!
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. The field goal would push it to sudden death. We just saw the field goal on the other end, but I don't think they are thinking field goal. At least not to start this drive, they're not thinking field goal.
Not at all, because your point is well taken. Yeah, kick the field goal, you push it to sudden death, but you're also kicking off and giving the other team the ball with a chance to kick a field goal and beat you. Get the touchdown, finish the game off. That has to be the mindset.
Where are they, team?
Alert 3, alert 3.
Alert three.
One.
On second down, it's Elliott. Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be third down.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense, and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
One. Three.
Mariota on third and two. The pressure. It comes, and he lost the football. Mariota had it jarred loose, and the Raiders pick it up. And he will return this one to the 30-yard line.
When I see a play like that, I come back to risk reward. I don't know about you, but is it worth it at that point, whatever you're going to pick up, to either take the hit, and in this case, lose the football.
So, should have gone down. I mean, hindsight's always 20-20, but that's the safe play.
You're exactly right. Hindsight's really never wrong, is it? Because you can analyze it, but I think ultimately you've got to look at it as a first option, taking care of the ball, getting what you can, and that's it. Don't worry about it anymore.
And they end this year just how everybody wants to end the year, holding the Lombardi Trophy. What a season for them. What a ride it's been for us as well here in the booth. For Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gunn. Thanks for watching, everybody. We will see you next season right here on EA Sports.